everybody. It is 11 o'clock. Let's get started. Okay, welcome everybody to another episode of Geering Up. We stream every single weekday at 11 a.m. Thanks everybody for coming in. I see a lot of regulars who are coming in. I saw Fiona earlier. Right now I see Sackett. I see Tree Tangled. So thanks a lot for coming in. And I see some people that I don't recognize. Thanks Cookie Space. So thanks everybody for coming in. For people who are new, if you're watching live, we have a live chat function for your questions and your comments related to our episode, so feel free to say hi. Just remember to stay on topic, please don't spam, and our moderator will help guide your questions and your comments. Our moderator today is Swati, so make sure you say hello to her in the chat. So she's going to compile all of the questions you have during the live stream, and at the very end, I'm going to try to answer them all. So today, we are going to be thinking about thinking. Specifically, why our body sometimes reacts without us actually realizing why or without us thinking about it. And specifically, that is known as our body's reflexes. Alright, so has anyone ever gone to the doctor and they bring in a little rubber hammer and they tap your knee with it? And have you ever wondered why your leg kicks out a little bit when the doctor taps your knee with that little rubber hammer? And the answer to that is our reflexes. But what is a reflex exactly? We might have a little bit of an idea based on that doctor example, but what are they? So a reflex is an action that you don't need to consciously think about. Your body just does it, and it's carried out by our nervous system. So our nervous system consists of our brain and of our spinal cord, and it helps our body perform two kinds of actions. Number one, actions known as conscious actions, and these are actions that we have to think about, and then we can do it. And then it also controls unconscious, that's the second type of action, unconscious actions. And these are actions we don't need to think about, but it seems like our body just does without us knowing why. So an example of this is, I'm gonna tell myself I'm going to count till three, and then I'm gonna go ahead and raise my arm. Ready? 3, 2, 1. So after I counted to three, I raised my arm, and I managed to do that. And the reason why is because I thought to myself, I told my brain, okay, I want to raise my arm after I count to three, and I was capable of doing that. So that's known as a conscious system, or a conscious decision, and it's mediated by my nervous system. So an example of an unconscious decision would be, I had pancakes this morning, and I can't tell my body, okay, now that I had the pancakes, I want to put the pancake in my small intestine so that I can digest it. Digestion is not something that I can think and have control of. It's something that my body just does, and no matter how hard I think I want to put that pancake in my small intestine, I'm not going to be able to do it because it's not something that I can control. So our nervous system does these two things. And a reflex is an example of those unconscious decisions, those decisions that we don't need to think about, but our body just does. So why do we need reflexes? What's the purpose of having our knee kick out, for example, when the doctor taps it with a rubber hammer? It must have a purpose. So our body has a purpose for everything that it has. And it's a product of thousands of years of evolution. So we had ancestors before us, maybe thousands of years ago, who had less efficient bodies. But throughout time, parts of our body has become a certain way to meet our needs, to meet our daily needs, to increase our chances of survival. And that's the point of our body, for us to survive. So our reflexes is another thing, another structure that helps us survive, and it helps protect us from injury. So it helps protect our bodies from things that harm it. For example, have you ever put your hand on something hot? I know if we forgot to do our safety check and I accidentally put my hand on a hot surface, you really quickly retract your arm. And it's before you can even say ouch or register that, wow, my hand is burning, it's on the heat and it's burning, I can retract it. And the reason why my hand retracts before I say ouch is because of my reflex. It first is an unconscious decision where I retract my hand. I don't control that decision, and that's my reflex. So we have other protective reflexes too in our body. It's not just retracting our hand from our heat. For example, there's blinking. So when something flies towards your eye, then you're going to close your eyes. And that's pretty obvious why, because you don't want to injure your eye. And we even have other reflexes like coughing and sneezing even. A lot of people don't know this. So coughing, if you have something lodged in your throat and you don't want something in your airway, you don't want food in your airway or else you can't breathe, you're going to cough. And what that's going to do, it's going to bring the food out. And similarly, sneezing, if you got something stuck in your nose, like some pollen, some dust, you're going to sneeze and it's going to help take that out. So we have these reflexes of coughing and sneezing that help prevent us from dying, basically, from not choking or from not having something in our nose preventing our airway from going, from preventing air to go into our airway, I mean. So in this stream, we're going to be doing something really interesting. We are going to hack our unconscious body system. We are going to demo three reflexes for you today. But first, we're going to talk about the specific reflexes and why we specifically have those. So what part of our body actually mediates reflexes? And we talked about this a little bit before, that our nervous system does it, but specifically, one part of our nervous system is responsible for reflexes mostly. So our nervous system consists, like I said, of our brain and also our spinal cord, this cord that just extends from our brain. And that cord, known as the spinal cord, is responsible for most of our reflexes. So most, not every single reflex, but what happens is there's receptors in wherever we hurt ourselves. Let's say we have a heat element and I put my hand on it. I have receptors in my hand that's going to say, hey, Santa, your hand is on a really, really hot element. Maybe you should retract it. It's going to send that signal. But instead of going all the way to my brain, having my brain process that, it's going to go to my spinal cord. My spinal cord is going to mediate my decision. So if it went to my brain, it would take longer. My hand would burn a little bit more. But since it goes to my spinal cord, then my spinal cord can tell my hand, hey, retract your arm. And I'm not thinking about that because when we think with our brains. We don't think with our spinal cords. We don't make conscious decisions with our spinal cord. When I think, oh, I want to raise my arm, I'm not doing that with my spinal cord. I'm doing that with my brain. So if my receptors in my hand go to my spinal cord, it tells me to retract my hand, then I'm going to retract my hand, and that's an example of a reflex. It's an unconscious decision that's going to make me retract my hand there. So the main thing that you should get out of this is that the spinal cord is responsible for a lot of these unconscious decisions that are like our reflexes that help protect our body from getting hurt. So now, what is an example of an important reflex? So the knee-jerk reflex is a really popular one because doctors typically do this. I've seen this on TV sometimes. When you see a doctor go into office, this is something that he tests. And the reason for this is that reflexes can tell us a lot about our nervous system. So what happens in the knee-jerk reflex? In the knee-jerk reflex, I'm gonna get a rubber hammer and I'm gonna tap my knee. What's gonna happen is I'm gonna kick out. And what's happening is I don't realize I'm kicking out. I don't tell my brain, okay, I should kick out my knee because this dude is tapping it with a little rubber hammer. No. What happens is when it is stimulated by that rubber hammer, the signal goes to my spinal cord and my spinal cord unconsciously will process that information and tell me to kick it out. But we said that every reflex has a purpose. It's evolutionarily designed to help prevent injury. And what injury does this prevent from? What's the purpose of this reflex? That's something that you might be wondering. So this type of reflex is really important for keeping your balance. So when you're standing up, gravity might cause your knee to bend slightly. And if we didn't have a mechanism to straighten that knee up, you could just fall over. So this reflex, once you have pressure there, it'll help straighten your leg, just like when you kick it out, your leg straightens a little bit. It'll help straighten it out so that you maintain your balance and you won't fall over and you'll be still standing upright. So that's the purpose of this reflex. And you can see just in the photo right above me, that shows the circuit right over there, that shows the circuit that the signal goes through. The stimulation is on my knee, it goes to the spinal cord, and then it comes back to the knee to tell me to kick it out. So it's fairly quick. You can see that it's like a circuit. It doesn't have to go all the way to my brain from my knee. That would take a longer time. And remember, with reflexes, since it's a protective mechanism to help injury, we want quick responses, then as quick as possible. What's an example of another reflex? The blinking reflex. We already kind of talked about this. So this is probably a reflex that you've experienced if you've ever had something unexpectedly thrown at you. I know in PE class, whenever we played dodgeball, I was not very good at dodgeball, and people would throw balls at me, and I would just react, and I would blink because they're being thrown at me. So if anything's ever thrown at you, your body's natural response is to close both of your eyes. So we talked about the evolutionary reason behind why we have the knee-jerk reflex. Now this one might be a little bit more intuitive. The reason why we close our eyes and why we blink like that is because the very outer surface of our eye is really, really sensitive, and if we get scratches on it, it can really harm our eyesight, and we don't want to injure our eyes. It's a very sensitive area, and vision is very important. So obviously we close it so that we don't injure our eyes. That one makes a lot of sense. Now here's another one you may have heard of. It's called the Babinski reflex, or sometimes it's referred to as the plantar reflex. Now this is a normal reflex in infants, but after a couple months of that infant's life, it goes away. So you can see in the video above, if you just scratch or just like get a sharp object and you kind of go and graze the foot, you can see that he separates his little tiny toes and the toes spread, and they call this a plantar flexion. And this is an example of the Babinski reflex. You just have the nice spreading of the toes. And that's normal in infants. However, once our brains and once our spinal nervous system starts to develop, that reflex goes away. And if that reflex comes back, if we see it in adults, then it can tell us that something is seriously wrong with our nervous system and that doctors need to do something about it. So this is a test that typically doctors will do. They might do it in the ER, in fact, and they will just graze a nice sharp object against your foot. And what should happen is either no reaction at all, nothing will happen, or your toes will flex towards that object. As you can see in the image right over here, you see the normal response is just a little flexing of the toes, or no response at all is perfectly fine. But if there's something wrong with your nervous system, then the toes are going to spread out and the back toe is going to kind of go back. And that's a positive Babinski response, which means that it's something to look out for, and it could be an indication of a deeper nervous system issue. Okay, so now is the exciting part. We get to do our own demo. We are going to demonstrate reflexes for you today and talk a little bit more about why they're caused. We're going to do three reflexes in particular. But before that, we're going to do our safety check. So remember, when we put pressure on our bodies, if we are going to tap our knee, we never want to do it with an object that will cause our skin to break. We never want to put so much pressure that it hurts us. Nothing should hurt in terms of reflexes. So be careful with the pressure that you use. There's no other safety hazards with this. We don't need a lab coat. We don't need gloves. We don't need eye goggles. And I actually encourage you guys to follow along and do this, or maybe do this after the stream. It's really interesting. Also, if you do a reflex test and you don't see the result that you're hoping for, if your knee doesn't kick front in the knee-jerk reflex, for example, that doesn't mean that anything is wrong with your nervous system. Maybe you're just doing it wrong. So if you don't see any response, or in the Babinski response, if you see something going wrong, then don't be too scared. You're probably just doing something wrong, and any indication of something wrong with your nervous system should be indicated by a doctor. What materials are we going to need? This demo is super simple. All we're going to need is your body, or you can have an assistant, or we can also use a small rubber hammer or a plastic object that will work to tap into our reflexes. I'm going to be using a stapler today. It's a little bit heavy. You're going to need an object that has a little bit of weight to it so that when I tap my knee, it'll kick forward. All right. Let's get into it. So I'm just going to move the camera so that you guys can see my legs. And what we are going to be doing first is we are going to be demonstrating the knee jerk response. So remember, that's the one where my knee kicks forward. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my stapler, which is a little bit heavy, and here's my leg, obviously. I'm going to try to tap right over here, right underneath my knee, if you can see that area right over here. And if I tap, I should see that my knee should kick forward, and my leg should kind of go forward like that. And I promise you, I'm not kicking it forward consciously. You might have to tap a couple times before you get it. Oh, that was a good one. I'm doing absolutely nothing here consciously. And if you tap harder, it does tend to go a little bit harder. Just have to make sure you do it in the right place. So what's happening there is when I stimulate right there in my knee and I give it a little tap, then the signal is going to travel up my leg. It's going to go into my spinal cord. My spinal cord is going to process it, and then it's going to send the signal back down my leg to my knee, and it's going to say, hey, there's some weird stretching going on in the knee right now. You should kick forward so that we don't hurt our knee. And that is why my knee kicks forward. So let's do the next demo. We're going to demonstrate the Babinski response. Remember, that's the one with our feet. So we're going to get our feet and a sharp object. You can even use your fingers. I'm just going to be using a clear ruler with a little bit of a sharp edge. Be sure not to exert too much pressure. This one's pretty easy to see. All you're going to be looking for is either no response at all, or my feet should curl towards the ruler. We should not see this kind of spacing of the toes and my toe going up like this. So if you can see my foot right there, I know feet are a little weird to look at, sorry guys. So I'm just gonna go from the very bottom of my foot, and then I'm gonna travel all the way up and around. So I'm gonna do that again, and you can see that nothing is happening. Some people tend to curl their feet towards the ruler. I'm not one of those people. As you can see, nothing is happening, which means there's nothing wrong with my nervous system, which is good. Remember, a positive Babinski response is if this happened, if I grazed it and then my feet went upwards like that. That's not a good sign for your nervous system, and doctors will probably do additional tests if they see something like that. If nothing occurs, however, that's good, because this reflex should be only seen in infants. You should lose it after a little while when you're an infant. The next reflex that we're going to show, sorry guys, let me just adjust the camera there. The next reflex and the last reflex we are going to show is our blinking reflex. Now, this is a pretty easy one to do. You can get an assistant to just get their hand and bring it close to your eye. You can't do this to yourself because you're anticipating my hand going towards my face, and I know I'm not going to hit myself, so I'm not going to blink. So what I'm going to do is, I got a little scrunchie right over here. I'm going to throw it at my face. Be sure, if you do this, to do it gently. And what should happen is that my eyes should both close like that. So let's test it out. You're looking at my eyes, they're open. I'm gonna throw this. And if you saw that, it was a little quick. I closed my eyes really quick. And it's because when something is thrown at your face, your natural response is to close your eyes to protect your eyes. You can do that with any object either. I got a cotton pad here. It's a pretty easy one to understand. It's a natural reflex that all of us probably have experienced. Okay, so that is the end of our demo. Those are just three easy reflexes that you can test at home. What I want you guys to do is I want you guys to do these reflexes, just do this demo at home. Take photos, or even a little clip would be really cute. And you can send it to the email that's in our description box below. And if you send it to our description box below, your videos and of you doing the reflex tests, and we can feature you in the next video. It's a new thing that we're trying, so please take some photos or take some little clips of you guys doing this, and we'll be sure to feature you, and that should be lots of fun. All right, so why do we need to care about reflexes? Why are reflexes important, and why do we learn about them? So they have a lot of applications in medicine, and they have applications in engineering too. So let's talk a little bit about medicine before we get into our engineering slide here. So in medicine, your doctor, when you go to the doctor, he's going to check your knee-jerk reflex. And we talked a little bit about this throughout the stream. And if he sees that there's something wrong with your knee-jerk reflex, that's going to tell him, maybe there's something going on with the spinal cord. Maybe Santa's spinal cord had an injury occur to it if I was in a car crash or something. And maybe there's something going wrong there. And it's just going to tell the doctor that he needs to check that out more. Same with the Babinski response. If that response, if the curling of the toes is present in adults, or not the curling of the toes, the flexing, then it should tell the doctor that maybe there's something wrong going there. So they need to investigate that further. But there's also an importance of reflexes in engineering. So biomedical engineers need to have a thorough understanding of reflexes, because there's some people that like to make robotic models of our body. They make little robots that behave exactly like our body. And why? It's so that we can test things and see how a body will react without actually using human respondents. So engineers make these robots that mimic our body, and they need to also have reflexes, because if our body has reflexes and these bodies are and these robots are mimicking our body, these robots need to have reflexes too. So what's really cool is you can see there's a paper that you can just see a photo of it up there. It has a very fancy long name, Artificial Homeostasis for Engineering Systems, Involuntary Reflexes and Physiological Inspired Controlled Applications. It's quite a mouthful, but what it basically means is that these engineers created these robots that actually have reflexes. So if they put their hand on something hot, they'll retract it, just like you and me. So it's really interesting to see the engineering applications that reflexes can have, even though it is, you typically think of it in terms of medicine. Biomedical engineers really do a wide variety of things. Okay. And with that, let's talk about what we talked about in this stream and summarize what we learned today. So we learned that reflexes are the involuntary responses of the body that serve to protect us. Remember how we talked about in terms of evolution, our body has developed these specific reflexes in order to help us survive in our environments. We also talked about how reflexes can be checked by doctors to evaluate the health of our nervous system. Remember we mentioned how the knee-jerk response, if it doesn't work properly, maybe there's something wrong with your spinal cord. And we also talked about how we're born with reflexes, and if you're healthy, you have them. And this includes the knee-jerk reflex, the blinking reflex, and the plantar reflex, also known as the Babinski reflex. And with that, I'm going to go on and answer any of the questions that you guys had in the stream. So if you have questions right now, feel free to put them in the chat. Let me just go check out the chat. Okay, my co-host has been sending me questions. So the first question is, will you be doing any online camps this summer? That's a great question. Yes, we will be doing online camps. There should be links in the description. We have our daily activity clubs, which are super fun, and you get to learn during the summer, which is great. So look out for that. We have another question. Do we control when we breathe? That is a great, great question. So we talked about how we don't control when we digest. But breathing is kind of a special one because I don't control at all how much I will digest. No matter how I think, I can't affect my stomach, my small intestine, my large intestine, anything. But breathing is special because it is under unconscious and conscious control. So think about it. If I tell myself I want to take a deep breath in and then breathe out through my mouth, I can do it. Ready? I can do it because I have control over my breathing, but it's limited. So I don't need to constantly think about breathing. Imagine how much of your brain that would use constantly having to think, okay, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. You would have to do that every second, right? So our body will actually make unconscious decisions to regulate a regular like breathing pace. And then if we are, for example, in a stressful situation, or maybe we're having a panic attack, or we're doing some yoga and we want to control our breathing, we also have control of our lungs there in order to control it, or the muscles that allow our lungs to inflate and to deflate, rather. So you do have some control over your breathing. Great question. We have another question, and that is, why is there brain in water? I think this means in our skull. Our brain isn't just sitting in our skull. Rather, it's floating in water, and the reason for this is the water, it's called cerebrospinal fluid, that's the big fancy scientific name. That fluid is a shock absorber, so what happens is if I hit my head on something, some of that fluid is going to absorb some of that impact, so it won't go directly to my brain. Remember, our brain is a really, really important part of my body, and I don't want to damage my brain. So that water, it's just a fluid that's surrounding it is going to help protect it from damage. Another question is our spinal cord attached to our brain? Yes, it is. So you have our spinal cord, and then you have some structures that are just in the middle, and then you have your spinal cord attached to that directly. Great question. Next question we have is, how many different reflexes there are? There are so many reflexes. I can't give you a number off the top of my head, but there are many, many, many in our body. There's little reflexes that might have to do with our arms. That would definitely be something to search up or that we can address in a Q&A. But our body has hundreds of reflexes. It's not like something that there's only two or three. I only gave three examples today because those are the easiest to check, but there's definitely a lot that doctors check too. We have another question here. Swati said here that there might be about 55 reflexes. So we do have a lot of reflexes in our body. We have another question. Is there anyone who can stop their heart beating for like a second? Okay, again, breathing is like one of the things that you can control, but there are some systems you don't have any control of consciously, so I can't think to myself, okay, I want to make my heart beat. Let's make it beat faster. I want my heart to stop. No, there's nobody who can stop their heart. But what can happen is, for example, adrenaline. If you're in a really stressful situation and stress is determined by your brain, what you deem as stressful, and then if you're in a stressful situation, your heart will start beating faster. So you can kind of control how your heart beats in terms of you can make it go faster if you're in a stressful situation, but you can't actively think, okay, I want my heart to beat. Not like that, but indirectly, you could say. Okay, I don't think there's any other questions. I'll just stick around for a couple more seconds. If you guys want to put any questions in the chat, I can go ahead and answer that. Just a recurring theme that I see is you guys are interested about the systems that you can control and can't control. Respiratory system, so breathing is one of the ones that we have a little bit of control on. But a lot of situations, we control our systems through like stressful situations and through our mind. And what I mean by this, that can be a little bit confusing, is if I'm in a stressful situation, my body is going to react a certain way. So my heart is going to beat faster, my breathing is going to be faster. You know, like if you run even, or if you're giving like a presentation in front of a class, that's how a lot of our systems are controlled. But directly, there's a lot of systems we can't think and control. Like for example, if you're in a stressful situation, you're actually going to stop digesting your food. And the reason why is because your body's going to be like, hey, you're in a stressful situation right now. Maybe digesting your pancakes isn't the priority right now. So you'll stop your digestion. But if I think to myself, I want to stop my digestion, I can't do that. So that's something to keep in mind. And I don't see any other questions in the chat. So it was great doing this stream today. Super interesting topic. Thank you guys for tuning in. I had a fun time learning about reflexes with you, and I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to come back tomorrow for another stream at 11 a.m. And thank you guys. See a lot of you guys going in the chat, so bye, Megumi. Thanks, Mahar. Thanks for coming. And I'll go ahead and end the chat, or end the stream. Bye, guys.